temperatures, perfect conditions for these two free-flowing sides. Leeds boss Steve Lawton told me in midweek that the inclusion of ex-All Black Craig Guinness at stand-off after only two outings was no gamble. I'm sure time will tell for the 22-year-old Aucklander. That pack will have to play very, very well in front of him for him to be positive in this game. No problems with that St. Helens pack. Very big, in form, as first-round victims witness will testify. And no one playing better than that man there, Kevin Ward. Nicol Harrison himself, careful of blasting holes in any Leeds diggers. Old Wellington lad, certainly tremendous interest for our New Zealand viewers. Side. Little bit of a confrontation there between Paul Dixon and Paul Bishop, but Dixon was healed. Well, I don't think Doug Lawton can be too upset about the tackling of his side. Mender, number 12, right, Paul Dixon, Great Britain forward, driving in. Harrison, Saints having real difficulty in getting out of this this territory. Bishop. Kevin Ward, not really seen him in action so far. In fact, Ross, we haven't seen St Helens really kick the ball since that first one from the kickoff.
No, St Helens haven't controlled the ball. They've been getting it and dropping in the first two or three tackles, so they haven't been able to sit down with any attacking play.
Griffiths gets the ball away well. This is good play for St Helens now. Oh, they've got Connolly on the outside now to Alan Hunt. He's got some space in here. Can he cut inside? He does. He gets it still going. To Griffiths, he gets it away to Cooper. Sullivan's got on the outside to Tierra Party. Oh, a beautiful pass! Beautiful pass from Tierra Party. Kiwi magic and a Kiwi scorer in Shane Cooper. That was the sort of classy rugby that St Helens can produce, and that's why they attract such a big support. Wonderful try and a classic pass at the end.
Yes, here goes Alan Hunt. He draws the fullback, steps inside, a flick pass here, a beautiful flick pass, and the ever-present Shane Cooper is there to put the ball over the line. Well, that was a classic try. That started from well inside their own 25.
And here we see, just look at this pass. The ball, it's beautifully judged. He takes Phil Ford out of the game. Then the cut inside. Is he held? No, the back pass. And that's good play by the skipper Cooper. Good support play.
Right, here's the Hunt, steps inside, passes the ball across the line, gives it to the 5'8 Griffiths, just as he hits the ground, passes it out to Cooper. Cooper then lets it go across to Sullivan, draws in forward, steps inside forward, and just as Tierra Party's about to be tackled, he slips the ball back inside, and Shane Cooper picks it up and scores what is probably one of the best tries in rugby league.
And that just shows what St Helens leading 4-1, Ross, yet Leeds had 75% of the possession.
Yes, I would have thought at this stage of the game that Leeds are looking the better side, but they're not backing each other up. It's one out running.
And St Helens are. This is wonderful support play. It's Phil Beavers again. Jonathan Griffiths is there with Connolly. Can't get it away. Good cover tackle in his life. Saints trailing. Sonny Nicol got that extra yard of pace. One or two quick men in these two packs. O'Neill in Leeds and Nicol here. Cooper, the good ball to Griffiths. Can he make half a yard? Rapati gets it out again. Good support play by Dwyer. Oh, he's got him away! He's got Connolly in! Yes! Connolly did well to dive in there, but it was the support player, second row, Bernard Dwyer. The hard-working front forward there, number 12, in the scrum cap. Put this lad in for his 14th try of the season. But it was support play again, as we saw with Saints' first try. So again in this one.
Yes, here it is. St Helens have moved the ball to the right-hand side of the field. Dwyer's got the ball. He takes them on. And before he's got the tackle, he releases the ball across to Connolly. Connolly sees the gap and dives for the...
That. Wonderful effort, Ross.
It is. Once again, there he is, right on the 35-yard mark. Just drops the ball. Heads it with a left... swinging with his right foot, swinging left, and over it goes, straight between the uprights again.
And that puts the two sides level again. 8 points each in his fourth drop of the season. Oh, mistake. Now then, that really puts the pressure on Leeds. Poor Mike O'Neill there, number 11. He'll regret that.
Territory. It's very dangerous to do what they've done there.
Cooper goes for the line again, and he's in for a try. The same try that he scored, and or made rather, for Paul Bishop against Widnes last week. The ball coming quickly out of the back of the scrum. Cooper picked it up, and he was away down that blind side.
Yeah, here it is here. Cooper picks the ball up from the back of the scrum. Lockford there, Deverty tries to tackle him. Cooper just pushes him away. Easy passage to the try line.
And that's Cooper's second try. Now then, the question is, yes, the ball was well out. He can detach himself from the scrum when the ball is out. And away he goes.
Come on, lad! Yes, Ray, Bishop's taken control of this game. He's got the St. Helens players doing exactly what he wants them to do. And when he moves the ball wide, he's got players there. Where Bobby Gourling just seems to be sitting behind his players, watching what happens instead of taking control.
Here is Bishop now, trying to take control. And it's Nicola Mansell going, and he's found the gap. He's got Sonny Nicola with him. Oh, but a crunching tackle.
A good tackle there, a good confrontation by the two halfbacks.
And a high kick. No, Mr. Whitfield not happy with that. A knock-on. The knock-on on the sixth tackle. And Jeanette Smith, the Saints physiotherapist, right on the spot. Ward. No. No way through there for Alan Hunt. The Hooter goes in all the excitement. What a 40 minutes. Wonderful rugby. Some exciting tries. Strong, hard forward play. And really, although St. Helens are winning 12 points to 8, this cup tie, very, very much in the balance. Anybody can win this. Perfect positional play from Beavers. Leeds have been in Wales this week. They went for a three-day camping stint with coach Doug Lawton, rather Spartan fashion, to restore team morale.
Here goes Sullivan. Great little hunt, makes a great run. As he gets pulled up, he unloads the ball across to Sullivan. He's got too much speed there for Morvan Edwards. Runs around him and takes the ball over towards the upright. Once again, the difference in the two sides is St. Helens makes a break, and they've got the opposite side winger who can back up.
This good break here by Alan Hunt, but Clive, son of Clive Sullivan, the Great Britain skipper, he's been troubled with hamstrings, but there's no trouble there, is there? It's sheer pace, style and class. Cooper. Good pass to Sonny Nicol. A forward with an extra yard of pay. Oh, he gets a good ball to Paul Groves. Now then, he makes space for Connolly. Connolly, he beats Morbid Edwards, gets it back. Just look at that possession there. Leeds, two-thirds of the possession, yet trailing. Cooper directing operations. Did well there. Now then, just look at these players. Cooper, the dummy, oh, rolls around the ground. Should that ball have gone out? I think it should, but it's still going. A chance here now. Bishop on the outside to Ward. Connolly's in. Yes! Support play extraordinaire again. There were five men there simply queuing up to take the pass. And suddenly, the pressure is off St. Helens again. Leeds hit back. St. Helens reply immediately. That's professional rugby. 16th try of the season for Gary Connolly. A stroll in for the youngster. He'll not score any easier than that.
Yes, here goes the ball. Straight down the middle goes Bishop. Gets it onto Ward. Overhead pass by Ward. Gives it to Connolly who strolls over. But what a great pass from Kevin Ward there. The deep front row. Possibly should have went to the line himself.
Young, 17 years old. Former England schools player, Gareth Stevens. Just in our screens there to the left. For David Creaser. So, can this injection of talent and speed make any difference? But a wonderful kick there again. He's punished Leeds many a time here this afternoon. Kevin Ward, so it's 17 stones, number 10, just assisting Connolly. And deciding, oh, he'll go himself, powerful run. He's got support again. It's in at the corner for Hunt, surely. He's in, yes, that's Pearce on the outside. Alan Hunt sends the youngsters into raptures. Sheer pace on the outside. That's where Leeds really have been cut to ribbons here at Headingley this afternoon. 18th of the season for this former Eastmoor amateur. And isn't he happy, Ross?
Yes, once again, Cooper's involved. Gets the ball, heads towards Hunt's wing. Throws a perfect pass, and Hunt does the rest of the work. Beats the cover defence to the try line. It was a great try. And it all started from that big man, Kevin Ward, going straight up the middle. Here he goes, powering his way through three defenders. Gives it to the ever-present Cooper once again. Cooper positions Hunt beautifully inside of his opposite winger, who then steps to the outside and then races the cover of the fence to the try line.
And this is how it all starts, with Kevin Ward, 17 stones, giant of a man, and a good pass, isn't it? Cooper on hand again, as a loose forward should be, backing up down the middle, but he's confident here, his Hunt. He goes round his man, pulls himself in. It's a try. And well deserved. Another local lad. Dwyer. Leeds number 8 there, Capel Hugh, worked very, very hard. And that again, isn't it significant to Ross? Leeds 53% possession, yet trailing badly. But it's St Helens on Bahur. And Rapati! Now then, it's a run. Rapati to Groves. He's got the wee one on the outside. He'll certainly score in the corner. Oh, Anthony Sullivan again. The difference between these two sides is sheer pace. Once that ball moves out, once St Helens throw this ball out, they're handing Leeds a lesson in running, in support play. And on the wings, Sullivan and Hunt, they're lethal.
Yes, here we go. Bishop goes down the middle, picks up Rapati, who takes everybody on, and then there's the hooker, Groves, coming straight down the middle of the field, heads towards Sullivan, picks him up on the outside of all the Leeds defence, and he just strolls over once again for a great try.
And here it is, and once again it's men. It's look at that, four men in support. Rapati is being overhauled, but along comes a hooker. A hooker, as he should be in midfield, and as a wingman should be, out there, puts his head back. It's a try. Good cover tackle, moved across well, but St Helens flinging this ball from man to man, from side of the field to the... Just look at this ball go. Bernard Dwyer creates the overlap. Connolly, oh, he's got Hunt away again. Is he going to go all the way? No, he doesn't. Good tackle by Gibson. It'll be a knock-on, surely. It is.
If that movement has gone half the length of the field, and look who's backing Hunt up on the inside then, but no other than Kevin Ward.
Very strong, stocky lad, made a good start to the game of rugby league. Oh, Rapati, superb sidestep. Now then, he's got Beavers with him. He looks for Sullivan, he comes into midfield. Now then, it's going to be a straight run between Sullivan, Stevens. He's looking for support, just look who comes along. But unfortunately, he drops it, Kevin Ward. Oh, a little nuggety Paul Bishop is there. And they're having a little right battle together, those two. Isn't he just like his father Tommy when he played for St Helens, Ross? I mean, they're just the same niggling little pests, aren't they?